My colour palette for all the art that I make has always been kind of monotone in some way, you know, especially with black and white photography and paintings in the past. And blue has this incredible meditative quality, and I wanted to keep the same tone and feeling that you know that it's still one of my works, and there's an emotional reflection within the surface. You almost feel like you're falling into the colour. It's not so sort of in your face. You sort of feel like you can quite tranquil when you're looking at it. When I make the stamp paintings, it's interesting because for me, the content of the painting becomes less important as I'm making the painting. It's a starting point, right? So I get influenced by great writers or philosophers or whatever I'm reading. But in the end, the words are my own. So I write a series of maybe 30 to 50 sentences of text. I then make them into rubber stamps and I start stamping the text onto the surface of the gesso. And it's that within that eradication and that mark making that it no longer becomes about what's written, it becomes about what the painting is, what the abstract work that's left makes you feel. It's not about the words anymore, they're gone. What you're left with is the imprint onto the surface and an emotion for the viewer to stand and look at it. It's also sort of, I suppose that same question comes with the music photographs as well. People really want to know who the composer is, and they need to have that information because they think it's going to change the way that you think about what you're looking at, but it's actually not. It's not what you're left with, it's just these marks and these notations. It doesn't matter what the score was. So the process of the music, the new music works, is quite playful because I put the paper in the bath of watercolor and I leave it there for maybe a day or so. So the paper takes on this incredible quality. And I didn't want it to be a sort of added color afterwards. So you know, you still when you go close to the pictures, you still see the fiber quality of the paper, and that's because the water soaks in and the watercolor soaks into the paper and leaves this incredible marks and dents and stuff like that. So it's actually more through play of choosing the colors and then through layering, the blue gets more intense, and then you know, and then in the end, it's just what works, right? My photographs have always been layered from the very first series of works that I made, where I collapsed a whole book into one picture. So this is amazing, you know, this compression of time, these compression of images. And I think that, you know, I got to that point because I was frustrated with the photographic surface. You know, there was always a sort of, in a way, a flatness to it that I was always very, I wanted to almost rebel against somehow. And I love this deception of whether you're looking at a photograph or a painting. That for me is very important. So the new White Windows series, sure, it's sort of like it's still the way that I make photographs, but I've been taking them for around about 5 years. And something very compelling to me about these windows around London, especially of boarded up shops or closed down premises, that you couldn't look into the window. It was almost like they whitewashed the past. But I also love this idea that the painter, if you like, was an anonymous person just clearing a window. He didn't have anything in his mind as a composition. And then you had this amazing sort of layered effect of all these different windows coming together. So in each picture there's around about 7 different windows, and then when you sort of start seeing the little reflections of the trees, of the little marks and the sort of marks on the window, then you realize that you're looking at a window. And I love that kind of reversal as the viewer. You don't know whether you're inside a shop or outside a shop. That's quite a beautiful thing to look at, I think. And it's nice that when you're walking around the show you're seeing these different layers of transparency. And this is the kind of first time I've used an ultramarine oil stick. And I love the transparent quality that you get because you still see some of the notations behind. And then the darker the oil stick gets, they start to look like little notes. And the reason I called it Quartet was it is a string quartet by Mozart. But for me, when I'm choosing the music that I'm working with, it's not about a particular composer. It's about the graphic, essentially. It's about the, I suppose, the compositional qualities of the music itself as well. So I kind of know what's going to happen. I know when the notes are going to jump out of the blocks. And I love the juncture position between the very clean, crisp line, almost defacing the music, but actually what you're left with is a different rhythm. You're more interested in the lines between the bars when you're looking at a composition like this, rather than the music itself. And somehow linked all the work in the show together.